All right, let's just look at a couple of log cancellation properties. Right here, we have log base A of A to the X equals X. Okay, in this case, the bases match. The base of the log equals the base of the argument, and the answer is just the exponent. So let's convert this to an exponential equation just to see why this is true. Okay, recall in the previous exercise, if we labeled this function here, this would be log base B of the argument A equals X. And if we converted that to an exponential equation, that would be B to the power of X. I'm sorry. No, that's correct. B to the power of X equals A. All right, so let's do that with this equation here. All right, and the log equation that's given in the cancellation property here, the base B is an A. So in place of B, I'm going to write A. And the exponent X is just X. And that equals the argument A. We can see the argument A is this whole thing right here. So A equals A to the power of X. All right. So if we translate All right, I made one little mistake here. We have B to the X equals A. We said the base B was an A and the X was an X. And the argument A is the thing you're taking the log of. And we can see here the argument A is this entire expression in parentheses, A to the X. So we're basically just left with A to the X equals A to the X, and of course that's true. All right, so this right here, if I can clean this up, I'll leave the parentheses. This right here is the first property. When the bases match, they just cancel and you're left with the X. All right, the second cancellation property is same thing, is basically the same thing when we have the bases match. A to the power of log base A of X equals X. Okay, this whole log expression is an exponent, and this base matches this base here. All right, so just like before, let's convert this to a logarithmic expression. Okay, right here, this is an exponential form. This is B to the power of X equals A. All right, remember that is your exponential form. B is the base that's being raised to an exponent, and that equals the argument A. So if we translate that to a log function, if we translate that to log base B of the argument A equals X, let's see if we can do that. All right, if we rewrite this here, we have log. And the base B is the number that's being raised to an exponent. So the base B is an A. All right. And the argument A right here, I'm sorry, I'm matching it to the wrong equation. The argument A right here is an X. All right. So in place of A, I'm going to write X. And the exponent X is this part right here, log base A of X. So as you see, we get the same thing on both sides of the equal sign. All right, so I'll just clean this up so I can leave this in the notes. But that is your proof that this right here is true. All right, so the bases cancel and you're left with X. And same thing here, the bases cancel and you're left with X. In both cases, you want the bases to match. All right, let's look at some simple examples here. We have 5 to the power of log base 5 of 2. All right, we see that this base matches the base on the log. So basically, we just cancel those bases, okay, and we are just left with 2. All right, these are all simple examples. Right here, we have the base 10 matches the base 10. So the 10s cancel, and you're just left with the 8. All right, the base 29 matches the base 29. Those cancel, and you're left with the 1. All right, see if you can do the last 4, please. Pretty simple. All right, base 4 matches base 4. So we are left with the X. The base M matches the base M. We're left with the R. Okay, remember the base on the log is the small number right here. And the base on the, in exponential form, the base is the number that's being raised to another exponent. So here, base E matches base E. That's a 6. And base 7 matches base 7, and the exponent is AB, or A times B. All right, pretty simple. All right, a couple simple properties you want to know here. This is in radical form, and if we wanted to convert this into exponential form, you want to remember that the root is this small number on the outside of the radical. That is your root. And the number that is right there is your exponent. Okay, if you convert that to a fractional exponent, the exponent itself is in the numerator. And the root is going to be in the denominator. All right. So we keep the A, the number that's being raised to an exponent. We keep the A. All right. And the exponent is in the numerator. So that's M. And the root is in the denominator. So that's N. All right, so this is in radical form, and this is in exponential form. Okay, also you want to remember, we covered this plenty of times for the negative exponents. If you take this whole thing and move it up into the numerator, you just change the plus minus sign on the exponent. So if we took a to the m from the denominator and moved it to the numerator, that's going to be a to the negative m. All right, so pretty simple. All right, let's look at some examples. So we said if we can match the base of the log to the base of the argument, that the bases could cancel. So here we have log base 9. And we want to write this 3 in terms of a 9. Well, we know that 3 is the same as the square root of 9. All right. So keeping log base 9, the square root of 9 is the same as 9 to the power of 1/2. Okay, in case you don't see what I did there, imagine the exponent on 9 was just 1, and the square root, the root of the radical, is just 2. Okay, when it's not written, it's automatically root 2, square root. So remember we said a minute ago, the exponent is in the numerator and the root is in the denominator. All right, and now we're in business. The nines cancel and we're just left with 1/2. All right, here we have log base 7 of 1 over 49. I'll keep the log base 7. And how can we write 49 in terms of 7? Well, I know 49 is the same as 7 times 7 or 7 squared. So we have 1 over, instead of 49, I'm going to do 7 squared. All right, so once again, log base 7. And remember, if we take this whole denominator and shift it up, we just change the plus minus sign on the exponent. So 1 over 7 squared is the same as 7 to the negative 2. All right, the 7s cancel. And we're just left with the negative 2. All right, see if you can do these two, please. We have log base 10. And we need to convert this to a fractional exponent. This is the same as 10 to the first power. So we keep the 10. The exponent is the numerator, and the root is the denominator. So this right here is the same as 10 to the 1/4. Now that base 10 matches base 10, we are left with 1/4. All right, once again, log base 10. And this is the fifth root. The fifth root, and instead of 100, I am going to write it as 10 squared, so it matches the base of the log. All right, so we keep log base 10. And we have a 10 here. The exponent is in the numerator, and the root is in the denominator. All right, so log base 10 and the 10 are gone, and we're left with 2/5. All right, so just a few more properties. Previously, we talked about the natural log being the same as log base e. So the natural log of e to the x is just x. And why is that? The natural log, that's equivalent to log base e. Okay, if we're taking the log base e of e to the x, the base of the log matches the base of the number with the exponent. So the e's cancel and we're just left with x. Same thing here, e to the ln of x, that's the same as e to the log base e of x. All right, when the base of the number with the exponent matches the base of the log, those just cancel and you're left with x. So that's why these are true. All right, and then here, log base 10. Remember, when there's nothing written, there's no subscript on the log, it's automatically log base 10 when the base is not written. So log base 10 of 10 to the x, the 10s just cancel and you're left with x. All right, and same thing here. We have a 10. The log does not have a base, so the log is automatically base 10. All right, when this base matches this base, you're just left with the X. All right, let's look at some examples. They want us to rewrite this in logarithmic form. Now, since I have an E right here, the E is the base of this term right here. So I am going to do log base E. On both sides of the equal sign. So on this side, log base e of e to the fourth is going to equal log base e of x minus 1. Okay, I just took the log base e of both sides. Here the base of the log matches the base of the argument. The e's cancel and we're left with a 4. And log base E is the equivalent of natural log, which is written ln, and that is ln of x minus 1. So that's it right there. All right, here we have 10 to the power of x. Since the base on this term is a 10, I am going to do log base 10 on both sides of the equal sign. So log base 10 of 10 to the x is going to equal log base 10 of 6. All right, here the bases match, so those are gone. We're left with x and log base 10. When it's base 10, you can write it without the base. So that's just x equals the log of 6. All right, in the next two, we're going to rewrite these in exponential form. So let's see. All right, so here we have the natural log of 2x. Okay, you don't have to rewrite it, but just to show you, once again, we know that the natural log is the same as log base e, and that is of 2x. All right, and on the other side we have a 25. And now what you could do here, since this is log base e, we are going to make this whole expression the exponent on the number e. Okay, so we had this part in red as our equation, and this is now going to be the exponent on the number e. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side, make the 25 the exponent on the number e. So I still did the same thing to both sides. And now the base of this whole thing matches the base of the log, so the e's are gone, and we're left with 2x, and that equals e to the power of 25. So this expression and this expression are equivalent. All right, last one. Here we have a regular log, so we know this is automatically log base 10 right here. All right, and since this is log, well, let me rewrite the whole thing first. All right, this will be log base 10. And that is 2x minus 9. And this equals 4. Now, just like we did with base e, here we have base 10. I'm going to make this whole expression the exponent on the number 10. Okay, this is going to be the exponent here in red. I want to do the same to the other side. This 4 is going to be the exponent on the number 10. And right here, since the bases match, they cancel. And we have 2x minus 9 equals 10 to the fourth. All right, so that would be the equivalent expression in exponential form. All right, see if you can do these three real quick. They're pretty easy, nothing to calculate. All right, ln is log base e. All right, I'm not even going to rewrite it. We know by now ln is log base e, and this has a base of e, so the bases cancel, and you're left with 15. Same thing here, ln is log base e, this is an e. They cancel and you're left with 14. Same thing here, ln is log base e, and here's an e, they cancel, that is negative 4. All right, try these three as well, same deal. All right, this is log with no base, and when there is no base, the base on the log is automatically base 10. All right, so this base is 10 and this base is 10. They cancel and you're left with 5. Same thing here, the log has no base, so it's automatically a 10. The 10s cancel and you're left with the exponent of 1/2. And same thing here, this is log base 10. The 10 and the 10 are gone. You're left with the exponent of negative 4.